Hi, I'm Sue Perks, and I'm one of the founding members behind the Symbol Group and Symbol 22 Symbol Sourcebook at 50 Symposium, which we are launching on the 7th and 8th of October this year. The Symbol Group is a new international discussion group for symbol-related matters, co-founded by Vibo Bakker, Jason Forrest, and myself. This year is the 50th anniversary of industrial designer Henry Dreyfuss' discipline-defining Symbol Sourcebook. The Symbol Sourcebook was very influential in its time, and Symbol 22 Symbol Sourcebook at 50 will explore its legacy and stimulate more interest in how symbols can be used to make the world a better place and break the language barrier that Dreyfuss hoped for in 1972. So how can symbols break the language barrier? A symbol is an immediately recognized expression which is not dependent upon a written language. It's dependent upon shapes and visual representation. The Symbol Sourcebook was published when the growth in internationalism fueled an increasing need for symbols to facilitate worldwide communication. Dreyfuss worked with symbols for all of his life. He'd been an industrial designer for many decades and designed symbols for his clients, companies such as John Deere and Polaroid. So he was engaged with the usability of symbols and how people needed them. The Symbol Sourcebook was Dreyfuss' retirement project, and it was ultimately an 18-month print and book design project based on symbols, many from his database, that he'd collected and used during his working life. The Henry Dreyfuss Archive at Cooper Hewitt Smithsonian Design Museum holds the design story of the Symbol Sourcebook. The collection was donated by Dreyfuss in 1972. It contains correspondence, symbol submissions, and all of the working material for the publication. The book forms just the tip of the iceberg. It's a day-to-day history of graphic design and industrial design for a period from the mid-1960s to early 1972. The Symbol Sourcebook was a crowdsourced project that enlisted the help of people across many disciplines to create a compilation of universally used graphic symbols. The team were meticulous in their research about each symbol discipline. So through the archive, you can see the way that the research process was networking around the world. Thousands of copies of the questionnaire solicited symbol designs, and the form was accompanied by, quite often, a personal letter, which described the project and said, "Have you got any symbols in your organisation?" Dreyfuss wrote to a colleague, "Symbols are all over the walls, all over our floors and literally coming out of my ears. And by mid-1972, I hope we will see a book on the market." The Symbol Sourcebook allows us to understand how different disciplines use symbols and how they fit into our lives. The Symbol Group and its upcoming symposium will examine the 50th anniversary of the Symbol Sourcebook to reveal its legacy, underpinning our current fascination with emojis, icons, and symbols, and explore new symbol applications. So, how are symbols breaking the language barrier?